Jesse Foote, tattoo artist out of Berkeley, California, but I'm an artist first and foremost.
Wow, I really like the beat. I got some shit up on my chest. I think it's time I preach. It's time
Probably the first time I ever attempted a tattoo was when I was 17, but I didn't get serious till I was 21. Tattoos is just something that I found that I enjoy and love doing. It's my favorite medium in art. What's crazier than a living canvas? If someone wants a sleeve evolved around the seven deadly sins, then I'm gonna channel that dark energy, you know what I mean? If someone wants something that's angelic, I'm gonna channel that energy. Black and gray is my first love, but I cheat with color every now and then. Reason why I like black and gray is it's more of a challenge in the sense that in order to create a heated mood or a liquid mood, you have to do it with shades and textures versus here's blue and it's cool, here's red and it's hot. I've done portraits of Jacques Cousteau, Einstein, people's past loved ones. So say I'm doing a portrait of Einstein, I'm reading about him the night before, even though we could all assume we know what he's about, but really get into it and feel it. I'm channeling that energy when I'm tattooing and I'm putting it down in skin. What stronger way to get into a perspective to create? When I see people from the last generation and what it is, and you could see the constant evolution as far as quality goes on tattoos. Even if you got one that you don't like, that you may not be fond of anymore, you know, it doesn't matter. It was a time in your life, and at that point in time, you were ready to get it. So let it sit like a history book. I don't care what the subject is you're getting tattooed. If it's big enough and a long enough session, your mind's going to go places where it may not normally go. And it's going to heal you because you're going to have to be faced with pain and struggle. And to me, my whole life that I've dealt with all of that has always gotten me to the next level. I had pop fluid pockets in my retina and they multiplied to the point where I was legally blind. I'll tell you to describe it the best was that if you're laying at the bottom of a 10-foot pool and you're looking out and it's bright, then the light is magnifying and it hurts your eyes. And if you are at nighttime and you're driving down the road, you'd maybe make out that there's a red light or a green light fuzzy in it. To be someone that at that point in my life, I'd already drawn as far back as I could remember. So to think that I wasn't gonna get my eyesight back, I didn't know if I was or not. And the consequences of my actions as a young person and the things I was into at the time that I was doing that, definitely is something that was a self-challenge that in the end I put myself through, but overcoming and getting out of that was amazing to me, and I've drawn every day since. My first 5 years of my life, the heaviest influence was watching my dad draw in his art room. He's very self-educated, hit the road, you know what I mean? He's been all over, he's lived life experiences, and I think I followed that, and some of the shit I dove into was head first, just the way that he did. It's your pops, that's your hero when you're younger. You want to be doing the same type of stuff that he's doing. I like to do all different mediums of art and pull them in. As far as what looks the most similar to tattoos, I would say charcoal. With painting, I like to evolve amongst the imperfections because to me that's what provides the illusion. You want to paint something to look like stone and you're trying to have control of every inch of it, it's probably not going to look that real. Yeah, I have a weird thing when I sign a piece, I won't ever fucking touch it after that because as soon as I sign a piece, anytime I've touched it, it seemed to be overkill all of a sudden. Like I did one touch too many. I stuck with something that I've been doing since as far back as I can remember. Artwork's one of those things that a kid can do that's like that. That's something I enjoy about having a youth around, you know, and especially my little clone because she's just an amazing person and totally brings it out of me. If I drew or made children's books based off the stuff she told me, I'd probably be a millionaire, you know, she's more creative than I am. I got pictures of her with the same knuckle tattoos drawn on when she was, you know, knee high. I have a skull in the center of my belly that she likes for me to draw on hers when the summertime comes around because she don't have to wash it off.
Take it and push like this. You want to jump around because you want to leave some black holes. Mm-hmm. You get some more paint on there. Just be free. Make it sloppy.
My daughter's huge. That was survival for me in a sense because I was 21 years old and got a kid on the way, you know, and quit my jobs and continued with this, and it's really paid off. Create equals meditation to me. We become our thoughts, do we not? And so for me to think something and bring it to life, it helps me structure my life and the things that are coming for me, and to paint that picture and start creating that. That's it for me, and I'm seeing it now, I'm living it now. That's where I'm at.